Hello, I'm MPX Toycat, and today a brand new snapshot came out for Minecraft Java Edition. It's a 1.17 snapshot, and it brings the goats for which we voted. You probably know that you can breed them with wheat and make baby goats. You might also know that you can milk them, and you get this brand new goat's milk. And obviously when you place the goat milk down, you get this delightful goat milk block. That's exactly what is happening here. Don't question that whatsoever. And the other interesting thing about this update, besides all of the powder snow changes, is they fixed a few bugs which really changed Minecraft. Did you know, for instance, that the underside of an end portal not being visible was actually a bug? You actually meant to be able to do this, which means that now, as of 1.17, you'll be able to see not only the bottom side of an end portal, but you'll be able to actually know what you're jumping into. And here's the even crazier bit, right? Oh, well, apparently the crazy bit is death. Okay, apparently that was a bug, but I've got two baby goats with me, and what's important is the fascinating little detail that, you know, even though, so they fixed the bug with the end thing, but then they introduced a brand new end bug, and that brand new end bug is so exciting to me because of how cool it looks. They accidentally changed end generation in such an exciting way that I need to show off in today's video. You know, all of the changes in this update are to do with powdered snow and goats, but what's way more exciting is what they've done with the end, and let me show you what that is, because the end is accidentally amplified. Is the only way I can describe it. So instead of having, you can see the end pillars are still there, the end spikes as they're officially called, and the end itself still does exist somewhere in that mess, but now we have, instead of just an end island, a single big one, we have this giant amplified end island with a bunch of islands surrounding that. Look just how incredibly cool this looks. I think it's really, really quite an astounding thing. Look at this just monstrously tall thing. You'll notice this goes up not quite to the end world height, which is 256. They didn't raise that like the rest of the world, but it does go up to about 200 blocks now, and so you get the end portal just kind of chilling by itself, which means, guess what? Do you want to fight the Ender Dragon? Well, in fitting with the Caves and Cliffs update, if you want to take down the Ender Dragon's towers, you know where you're gonna have to go to do that? You're gonna have to mine down through the end stone. That's right, you can see right here just how insane this looks. Not only the weirdness of all of the caves, but look at that. There are these end pillars which exist inside these little cave-like structures. And again, I wanna be clear here. This is 100% a bug. This will be fixed. This won't make it to the final release. As cool as it would be if they did, that doesn't seem to be their plan. But the fact is, they have accidentally made a really cool little end modification that, like, I feel like something has to be done with this. Whether it's a map, whether it's a custom option in the Minecraft menu from now on, this bug is incredible. The end terrain is really quite an astounding thing, and yeah, in case you go to the end in the current update, here's another reason not to play. Oh, actually, this is a reason why, even though snapshots are buggy, you might enjoy playing them. Just don't put your long-term survival worlds here, because you don't want your world to be ruined like this. Or maybe you do, actually. Again, I think this is crazy beautiful, and maybe the dragon disagrees, but it's not her right to do that. Also, apparently you can't damage the dragon. Oh, I guess it's just very weak damage with just my fist. I thought this would be true, but because the dragon is so high up, she actually doesn't get any healing from those crystals anyway. So yeah, this is broken on so many levels, but is this not one of the best things about this update? I'll talk about it more after we quickly mention, hey, did you know powdered snow is in this as well? So powdered snow, unlike the earlier versions you might have seen in Bedrock, or indeed on Java, now exists in a bucket. It's been like that for quite a few weeks, but it's something I want to mention because not everyone follows every snapshot, and if you do follow every snapshot, then you know what? I feel like my videos aren't the ones people who follow every snapshot and want to see every minor update, because I like to focus on the big changes and the weird things they're deciding to do, and powdered snow is something they have decided to take a big stance against, or rather a big stance for. A stance I can talk about by going back to the overworld. Did you know that we can see the portal from underneath? We can see it from above, but there's still a rendering glitch where we can't see it from the side. There is a mystical invisible block there. You know what? They fixed one of the bugs. That's what's important. Wow, we beat Minecraft. It was really cool, wasn't it? Anyway, this snapshot has a very clear function, in my opinion, in terms of its big one picture move, and that is to make powdered snow more terrifying. Right now, you know, powdered snow looks like a goat milk block. It's hard not to see it that way a little bit, right? And also, it's not that terrifying, especially if you put some leather boots on, but even if you didn't have leather boots on, powdered snow wouldn't be that terrifying before. So now the way it works is the freeze effect takes about 7 seconds to apply, and once you get the freeze effect, it's just 2 seconds until it starts to damage you. If you haven't seen already, the damaging from frost is a pretty cool new effect. Obviously, this isn't a block that naturally spawns yet on the Java Edition, But it looks like they've seen the bounce of it, and they feel like, you know, they want to make this more dangerous. Partially so that the mountains actually have some threat. If you go in there with no idea of what you're doing, you can actually die by going to... Oh, look, the little goat is concerned about my life right here. So you can actually die by going into one of them a little bit easier than you could otherwise. Just bring some boots and it's easy. But also, the goal is if you're making a custom app or something, again, lots of Mojang decisions seem to be driven by the community decisions on the end of that. And so, like, yeah, it would make sense that frozen snow should actually be, or powdered snow, should be something you can do some real damage or some fears to people with. So, yeah, that is powdered snow. It is being seriously revamped. Also, in the same update, they've made a few other kind of key changes, in my opinion. And I'm not just talking about goats, because, again, we've had goats on Bedrock for a while now. You've probably watched the videos about it. If you haven't watched them, hey, did you know goats exist? Did you know they're adorable and they do a bunch of jumping? Do you want to see some goats jump? Let's watch some goats jump, shall we? Come on, I believe in you. You can do this for me. Gotta make my video exciting. People don't watch YouTube videos without bouncing goats in them. We all know it's true. You gotta perform for me this time, Mr. Goat. Oh, there we go. Baby goat jump. Oh, big goat jump. There we go. Look at that. See, now, no matter what you say about the rest of this video, it did have a goat jump in it, so is it really that bad? Anyway, so with that said, let's now move on to the next key change they've made. By the way, I would like to just point out, glow squid do in fact spawn in caves. Wow, isn't that fun to look at? Also, I'd like to point out something that is effectively a Bedrock equivalent coming, but it's very interesting. There is a brand new block that you can find only via commands, and it's called the light block. So this is a light block. Unlike on Bedrock, where you can type in just a variant of the block, on Java, the light block by default is light 15. I think that's so much smarter than light level 0, so there's something the Bedrock team could take away from that. Let me just do this one more time, show how it works underwater, show how it works in a cave, show how it works. If you want to light up an entire space, we could go like 10, 10, 10, make a giant cube of light if we want to. The light block is one of those Bedrock exclusives that is finally moved, but there's a lot of really smart things, such as it doesn't overwrite other blocks. As you can see, the stone wasn't overwritten by the light block. Oh, no, never mind. If you place light, it does actually destroy all the blocks around it too. So, as you can see, there is this delightful light block over here. Look how nice and lit up it is. So yeah, again, just like I was saying, unlike on Java, unlike on Bedrock, where it's assumed to be zero by default, you can have a light level zero block. It's not a very smart idea. It's just kind of removing all the light from an area. But if you want to have zero light level that comes in via that block, you can do it. If you want to have max light level, like you probably do, you can do it. Or if you want to go somewhere in between, if you want to have like a tiny bit of light, so let's say light level, like, I don't know, 2, you can do that. So like you can see things. It's fine, but also it's kind of dim. So yeah, that's one of those Bedrock exclusives. It's cool they added it. A lot of people think it's a brand new thing, but like many great items, it's a Bedrock exclusive. Also, don't dungeons look so much cooler below Y0? No, we have to focus on the video subject today. It's very hard when there are cool new caves to explore. But the coolest new thing about this, in my opinion, is the changes to the abandoned mineshafts. So abandoned mineshafts now can have taller lengths for their pillars and taller lengths for their chains, as I'm showing off in this horrifically not very tall mineshaft. This is actually one of the coolest looking mineshafts I've seen in a while. Like, isn't there just something so cool about this? You go under another part of the mineshaft to get down there. I love this, but it's not what I'm looking for. By the way, they tried to write an algorithm that could make the pillars avoid lava or spawning anywhere too close, but they weren't successful with it. So you will still find mineshafts next to lava, partially because it was too hard to do it, but also because of the fact that they just figured it was kind of a fun behavior that sometimes you had a mineshaft that caught fire. So that is semi-intentional, is how I would describe that. They could fix it, but they decided it's probably better not to. Okay, so this is a really weird example, but I'll use it anyway because it's, I guess, it's a bit more natural compared to what you expect right now. You can see that the supports are going to be much taller, or allowed to be much taller. So look how tall these chains are, for example. This is a change they made to mineshafts. They've made a lot of tweaks, in fact, to the underground, as they're doing every week. I don't talk about every change every week, but they've made diamond ores sometimes generate more, and also they've increased iron spawning. Basically, every week they look at some feedback, they look at how the game is performing, and they're like, yeah, we could do a little bit more iron and diamond. This is really the best bit about the snapshot process. When the update comes out, it'll be fine-tuned, hopefully to provide a good survival experience to the many, and not just like in theory, you know, which is something I love a lot. Also, this ravine, again, it's I just have to be interested by this stuff. This is the surface, This ravine goes so deep because it's one ravine that goes into a second ravine, and then that second ravine goes straight down to Deep Slate Lair. I wonder if that'll be like the new like barometer for like how deep a ravine is. A ravine that can go like deep into Deep Slate and all the things that come with that, because this then has a third ravine that goes even further in. That and then there's more even. That would be something that would be very interesting to see. And yeah, did you know Minecraft has many updates? Did you know that? Speaking of things that you should know, did you know goats are very goaty? They are goatier than they were before. Wow, this is shocking knowledge coming off the heels of an IBX Toycat video. But yeah, goats are everywhere. They keep the llamas company. It's very cute. And now we finally get to, okay, we've made a full video. Can we talk about what I'm here for? Okay, so the end portal, which I have to mention, very, very interesting stuff, right? So we'll like raise that in the sky. Here is what a block of those looks like now. You can actually see it from both above and below. So it gets even more interesting to me. Like, just look at this. This is the most incomprehensible block to look at now. And somehow making it more logical made it less logical to me. Like, am I looking at a cube right now or a lot of individual layers? It actually is kind of tricky to tell, right? Anyway, so if we go to the end, I really like this accident thing that they've done here. I love the new end with the baby goats that accidentally went through the portal. I'm sorry, guys. But I love this accidental end. And I feel like this is a good, like, I feel like this definitely shouldn't be how the default end is, sure. But I think this might be a fun setting for when you're playing Amplified. This might be fun inspiration for what to do in any future updates. Because with absolutely no trying, with just breaking the game by accident behind the scenes, Minecraft has accidentally created one of the most fascinating end fights that at the very least is going to be inspiration for something I do in the future. I don't know what. I don't know why I'm so inspired by this, but I love it and I'm fascinated. And I just want to say, maybe we should make this not a bug. Or maybe we should just not fix this bug. That's all I'm saying. Again, of course it has to be fixed. I know it does, but I think it's so interesting. And maybe you do too. Maybe you prefer the goat milk block. Or maybe you don't prefer anything. Maybe what you really do is you just hate everything in life, and you find that watching Minecraft videos is only filling the void for a little bit before the hatred comes right back. And in that case, I would have to recommend, I don't know, therapy. Or maybe, you know what, this is the internet. There's no such thing as therapy. What you do instead is you go on social media and you leave mad comments about how it's everyone else's fault. And then, once you've done that, I say, thank you for watching this video. Make sure to leave me a negative comment about how the fact that something you didn't like was my fault, and then we can make it better. Yeah, that's what we'll do. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you all in the next one. Wait, what happens if we send the Ender Dragon through an end portal? Can she do that? I've never tried. You know, no, the video's not over yet. The video's not over till it's over. She has to come through here, right? There we go. No. I don't think she can go through. Unless she, like, her whole body has to or something. Yeah, that's so weird. The Ender Dragon can't go through end portals. That's so sad, you know? You'd figure she would be able to, but apparently not. So yeah, we'll just watch as she doesn't get subsumed by these giant blocks. And I'll say, hey, did you know subscribing to the channel gives you slightly lower odds of dying in a house fire? Bet you didn't know that one. I bet I haven't mentioned that in any previous video. That's the real reason your house caught fire. It's because Toycat keeps mentioning it, damn it. Oh, it's so weird when you remove... I'm removing the blocks here, but they're not actually vanishing because I can just see the one below it. Oh, this is going to be fun to play around with. See, 1.17, it's got some great features in there. You should totally check out. Goodbye.